Hello, everybody. PJ Anderson here again. It's evening already, Saturday evening. And basically, it was another really good day. God allowed me to share the gospel with other people when I even went out shopping, which is one of the things I do a lot of since I'm retired. I'm going to continue with Daniel. This is another part of it. And what I have seen in chapter 2, what happened is King Nebuchadnezzar built a huge statue. He created a rule that everyone was supposed to worship it. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused to worship that statue. And when doing so, this made Nebuchadnezzar very furious. Because of the rule, they were going to be thrown into a fiery furnace with the flame 7 times hotter than they ever were. So they were bound, they were thrown in. While in that furnace, an angel came. And this could have been Jesus. The Bible is not specific, but it could have been Jesus. And Nebuchadnezzar saw 4 figures in there instead of 3. And he was completely surprised by this. He also saw that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were not tied up anymore, okay? And then what he ended up doing is calling them out of the fire to come to the presence. And what amazed Nebuchadnezzar is there were no signs that they had even been in a fire, or no smoke on their clothes, no singed hair, nothing like that. And this impressed Nebuchadnezzar, and he did make a command that everybody worship the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And the thing is, he did not totally repent. He was just did this, and he did promote Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now in chapter 3, Nebuchadnezzar had another dream. And within this dream, what ended up happening is he had a hard time, okay? In the dream, it talked about the heavens, the earth, the ground, and some things that are unusual. It did not say, you know, he could not understand that he would be changed if he continued to sin. And because it troubled him, he asked the wise men again, the sorcerers, magicians, to interpret the dream for him, but they could not. So Daniel did talk to him and interpreted the dream. And Daniel informed Nebuchadnezzar that if he continued to sin, the dream would come true. Well, Nebuchadnezzar did continue to sin. And one time, while he was in his palace, talking and looking at the stars and things, what ended up happening is like he went insane, and he ended up leaving the palace. His hair grew long like the feathers of a bird. His claws also, his fingers and nails grew long like those of a bird. And he lived this way off the land for 7 years. And then after that 7 years was completed, Nebuchadnezzar looked to the heavens, and he was changed back to normal. Now, after that happened, Nebuchadnezzar, his eyes were opened, and he again changed. So, what I'm telling you here, okay, is that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego put their lies in the hands of God, as they did in chapter 1 with Daniel. God took care of them. They weren't burned. Nebuchadnezzar continued to not believe in God completely, followed his evil ways. And he continued to sin, and he changed. And then when he realized after the 7 years, and he looked to the heavens, he changed back. And when he realized that he was a sinner, and that his sins were pretty bad, he repented. So we need to put our hands in and put our lives in God's hands. And we also, if we are going to sin, we need to repent each and every moment of each and every day, even though we are forgiven. We need to love God completely with our mind, our heart, and our soul. And this is important. And I'm hoping that everybody has a good sleep tonight, and has a blessed evening tonight, restful, and hope to see you again in the morning. God bless.